Checkpoint Jumpstart Training is a series of training courses that help you understand and configure Checkpoint's wide range of products and their portfolio. My name is Manuel Joking, and I will be a technical trainer for this training module. In this training course, we're going to dive into Checkpoint Quantum product line. Specifically, we'll be discussing multi-domain security management server. And here, I will explain the purpose and the need for using it. And we also will be demonstrating how to configure it. Now let's get started with our first lesson. Lesson 1. What is multi-domain security management server product? In previous Jumpstart training courses, we mentioned that Checkpoint architecture can be broken down into three main components. First, we have the Smart Console, which is the GUI client component. Second, we have the Security Management Server, which contains the database and the security policies. And third, we have the Security Gateway, which does policy enforcement. These are the three standard components. But in this training, we're going to replace the Security Management Server with the Multi-Domain Security Management Server. And so make sure you have a basic understanding of what a Security Management Server does before continuing. I like to imagine that a multi-domain server is an enterprise version of the Security Management Server. Or better yet, a multi-domain security management server is an enterprise version of the management server that houses multiple security management stations. In essence, a multi-domain security management server can house multiple security management servers on one platform. But in order to fully explain the multi-domain security management server product, MDS for short, we will need to first explain the need for MDSM. Why would a customer need and want to purchase it? Let's step back a little bit. We have two primary type of customers that have a need for multi-domain security management server. The first type of customer is a reseller or a managed service provider who manages multiple customers. The second type of customer is a medium-sized or a large enterprise customer that manages multiple data centers. A multi-domain security management server is a multi-tenant solution, meaning each tenant can be a separate company or a separate enterprise or even a separate region. Basically, a tenant can be considered what we call a domain. The definition of a domain is usually where we have one security management server and one or more security gateways. And this obviously will depend on customers' environments. So a domain always has a security management server that manages one or more security gateways. A customer's network environment can be broken into one or more domains. A domain is a grouping of computers, which can be broken down by customer, by region, and by group. Now let's do a couple of scenarios to make sure this is clear. Scenario number one is the first type, which is a managed service provider, which can be a reseller that manages multiple customers. Let's start the scenario with a managed service provider that has three customers. Let's call them customer X, customer Y, and customer Z. So our service provider manages three separate customers, X, Y, and Z, and so they need to keep the customer's data segmented and private. In a traditional Checkpoint architecture configuration, they will need to have three security management servers, one for each customer. And so in this example, we can also say that each customer is a separate domain. So we have three customers, which means that we have three domains, one domain for each customer. So we have domain X, domain Y, and domain Z. We need to have three separate security management servers because we need to keep the domain's data separate for privacy and other security reasons, which means that we cannot have one security management server to manage all of our three customers. Because if we did, if we had only one security management server to manage all three customers, then each customer would be able to view all the other customers' network topologies. And so for security reasons, we want to be sure that each customer is only able to view his own domain and only his data that is part of his domain. And so another solution is to use our multi-domain security management server. Our multi-domain security management server solution is an enterprise management security solution that can house multiple customers, multiple tenants, multiple domains on one system, and each domain will be a separate company. So in our first scenario, a better solution is to replace three separate security management servers with one single multi-domain security management server. And each domain will be stored in a separate container that manages a single customer. And so each customer will only be able to view and manage only his appropriate domain, his data, and his information. But we're not just using any hardware appliance. Here we're talking about a high-end checkpoint appliance that can run our multi-domain security management solution software. And so on this multi-domain security management appliance, we need to create three separate domains, one for each customer. That's why we call it the multi-domain security management server, a multi-tenant solution. And each tenant, meaning each customer, will be a separate domain running a multi-domain security management server. Each separate domain will be like running a separate security management server. And so even though the domains are running on the same appliance, it will be like running on a separate server with separate domains, because each domain will be housed on the separate container, a separate database, and separate folders. And so no domain data, which in this case means no customer data, will be accessible to any other customer from any other domain. And so we did not only replace the hardware, but we also replaced the software. We replaced three separate hardware appliances running security management server software. And we replaced them with one single security hardware appliance running our multi-domain security management server software. And then we spun up three separate domains, one for each customer. Each domain on the multi-domain security management server will act just like a separate security management server. And just like separate security management servers, each domain will house a separate customer security policy in a separate folder. And so no customers will be able to view any other customer's data, like networking topology or security policies or any other customer security data. And so you can obviously see the value and benefits of using multi-domain security management server. And so we are saving on total cost of ownership. We are saving on hardware costs by replacing three hardware appliances with only one hardware appliance. And so we are saving on electricity costs. Instead of powering on three separate appliances, we're only powering on one appliance. And it also goes to reason that we're also saving on cooling costs, air conditioning costs, office space, and racking space, etc. Also, have I mentioned that one multi-domain security management server can house up to 250 tenants, meaning over 250 domains, 250 customers, all running on one single hardware appliance? And so if you compound that, you can imagine the savings in hardware, software, air conditioning, and power supplies for a really large service provider. And so you definitely can start to see that this solution is extremely valuable to a managed service provider that supports multiple customers. But this is not a sales video, but a training video. So now let's take a look at another scenario. And so how about if the customer is not a reseller or a service provider? Can an enterprise customer still take advantage of a multi-domain security management server solution? And the answer here is yes. This product can still be used by a big or large enterprise customer. Let me explain this. Remember, a domain can be broken down by a company or a business unit or by department or group or by branch office or by any other geographical region or location. And so now let's take a look at a second scenario. In this scenario, we'll be using a large enterprise customer. Now imagine a company with one domain, maybe it's a sales or other geographical region. Let's call this region 1. Region 1 is being managed by security management server 1. And this would not be a large enterprise if it only had one domain. So many years later, the company situation changes and they need to grow and expand, Perhaps they also need to have another domain. Remember, a domain can contain one or more multiple security gateways being managed by a separate security management server. And so if they open another office in the second location, let's call this region 2. And again, they need to have a separate management station to manage this region. Now you probably could use the same security management station to manage both regions, but perhaps for performance or bandwidth issues, or maybe better yet, to keep better separation of administrative duties, they decide to keep both regions separate. So they need to put a secondary security management station to manage the second region, region 2. So let's add another management station. Let's call this the security management station 2. Again, remember that this is the same company, a large enterprise customer that has two domains, one for each region. Domain 1 contains region 1 gateways, which are being managed by the security management server 1. And domain 2, which contains region 2 gateways, which are being managed by the security management server 2. And if this company keeps expanding into other regions, and if they need another domain, a third domain, let's call it region 3, and this third region needs to be managed by a security management server. And we could technically use the same security management server 1 or security management server 2 to manage this third region. But to continue with our segmentation scenario, perhaps for separation of logs, perhaps we will need to add a third security management server 3. And as they keep expanding and adding more regions, they might need to add more security management servers to manage those regions. But I think you get the idea now. So we'll stick to only using three regions in our example. Now, one other thing that I need to make sure that this is clear, I have been using regions as a breakdown for our domains. And this is just as an example. Remember, a domain does not have to be a separate company like in our first scenario. A domain does not have to be broken down by regions as in this second scenario. What I'm trying to say is that a company doesn't just need to be expanding into regions to take advantage of a multi-domain security management server. As I mentioned before, a domain can be broken down into many different company entities. A domain can be broken down into, let's say, different departments. A company can have, say, the sales department, the marketing department, the engineering department. A company domains can be broken down into different work units. They have the headquarters unit, the remote office unit, and the help desk unit. Or a company's domain can be broken down into anything as needed. One more and final example, a company's domain can be broken down into work groups. They can have the finance group, the payroll group, the HR group, and I think you get the picture. With that out of the way, let's get back to our scenario. Also, each domain will have one security management station, but it could have one or more security gateways. Let's say Region 1 has 5 security gateways, Region 2 has 7 security gateways, and Region 3 has 4 security gateways. I only mention this because a domain can also be broken down by not only how many security gateways each management server manages, but also another consideration is where are the security gateways located and who will be managing those security gateways, meaning where are they going to place the security management server. And to wrap this up, we can see that each security management server manages a few gateways that belong to the same domain. Security Management Server 1 manages 5 security gateways in the domain called Region 1 domain. The Security Management Server 2 manages 7 security gateways in its domain, which is the Region 2 domain. And the Security Management Server 3 manages 4 security gateways, which are part of the Region 3 domain. Now, it's even possible to even imagine a company that is large enough that can have 100 or more security management servers, that in turn manages thousands of gateways. This is not hard to imagine. We have multiple customers like that. You might be even working for one of them. But to keep this simple and for explanation purposes, I'm using the example of a company with 3 domains three domains will require three separate security management appliances with multiple shelving rack space and cooling supply needs. Again, that's where the multi-domain security management server, the MDSM system, comes in, which offers multiple benefits and values with multiple cost savings. We can replace three or more security management servers with one single hardware appliance running the multi-domain security management server software. And so now here we have only one appliance, and this appliance will house three or more separate domains. Domain 1 will manage region 1, domain 2 will manage region 2, and domain 3 will manage region 3. Or let me state this another way. Domain 1 is the management container that runs on the MDSM server that manages Region 1 security gateway policies and network topologies. Domain 2 is the management container that manages Region 2 security gateways, policies, and network objects and servers. And Domain 3 is the management container that manages Region 3 security gateways and their security policies and the rest of its security network environment. And so each domain, even though they're running on the same multi-domain security management system, for practical purposes, they're completely separate tenants. And so all data will be segmented separately. But because in this case, we're talking about a large enterprise customer, you could create an administrator with permissions to one or more domains if needed. And so to recap, in this lesson, we talked about the multi-domain security management server and what are some of the reasons for having a multi-domain security management server. And we mentioned there are two primary customers that could or would require the need for multi-domain security management server. The first type being a managed service provider that manages multiple customers. And the second type was a large enterprise customer that had a few data centers or regions or departments. And finally, we mentioned that a domain is a container running on a multi-domain security management server that acts just like a security management server, and that you can break down a domain either by a company, as an example for a managed service provider, or you can break down domains by departments or region for a large enterprise customer. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next lesson.